Hi everybody, my name is Chris. I love designer handbags. I love talking about designer handbags. And so today I'm going to be doing a review of my Louis Vuitton Speedy. Mine is a little bit different from everybody's brand new Speedy because usually when you buy a Speedy, people get a monogram canvas. To be honest with you, when I first saw Louis Vuitton and first became familiar with it, I really didn't like the monogram canvas. I know. But then I found out about the epi leather. I absolutely loved the epi leather. I fell in love with it and I decided I had to have it. So I purchased my first bag, which is my Speedy right here. It is a size 25 and I got it in the epi leather. So some of the details here, you can see that it has the gold tone hardware. This bag is made in France, and I've been told that when the bags were made in France, they were actually genuine brass fittings. I can't verify that. It may or may not be true. However, based on the condition of the hardware, it seems to me as if it probably was. So it's a top handle bag, which has a short drop right here. You can carry it in your hand. You can wear it on your arm, but you will not be able to get it up over your arm onto your shoulder. It's just not going to fit that way. So it's really meant to be carried as a top handle bag. The links here make it easy to open and close the handles, preventing creasing. And then of course there's the rivets. All of the rivets on the bag have Louis Vuitton embossed on them. Okay, on the interior of the bag has one pocket right there, which is an open pocket. It doesn't zip. And then on the opposite side, there is a D-ring right there, which you can clip your keys to. Or if you have a pochette that you might like to carry with this bag, then you can clip that on there as well. On one side there is a pocket. It's a narrow pocket though. You're not going to fit a lot into this pocket, as you can see. Maybe like a ticket from a parking garage or something like that. That's about it. The zipper itself goes the entire top length of the bag. So from one side of the bag to the other, making it a pretty good size opening for this particular bag. The dimensions of the bag are about 10 inches wide, about 7 inches high, and about 7 or 8 inches high, and about 6 inches in depth. So it's on the smaller side. However, because of the shape of it, I feel like it really carries a lot of items. And one of the cute features of this bag is that it does come with this little lock that hangs there. Now I still have my keys, and so I will show you how that works. What you're meant to do is unlock your lock that's hanging on the side here. Grab the pull tab that goes right here. And you can see this pull tab on the zipper has a hole in it. And then you can just put the lock through the pull tab on the zipper and through the tab on the side there. And then you can attach your lock and lock it right there. And now your handbag would be locked. But let's be honest. Who locks their handbag? I've never locked my handbag, and frankly, if I did, I'd probably have my key ring inside, so what on earth am I gonna do with these little keys, right? Nevertheless, it is still an option. It is kind of a fun thing that's hanging down there, and hey, if you wanna lock your handbag, you go right ahead and lock your handbag. I personally have never done it. I've always just left the lock hanging right here as you see it on the bag. So I purchased this bag in 2002, which makes it about 16 years old. And at the time that I got it, it was about $680, which at the time I thought was really a lot of money. However, looking back on it now, I realized that it was well worth every penny because it has kept its appearance up so well. And like I said, I've had it for 16 years. When I first got it, I carried it nearly every day. In all kinds of weather, and it doesn't have any feet on the bottom. It does have this leather trim though. So even without any feet, the ends here are still in really good shape, and it overall looks really fabulous even today. So I'm gonna show you what fits inside my bag. I carry a lot of things with me, and these are not anything unusual. I have reading glasses. Then I have a really big pile of keys, and yes, I do need all those keys. Here are my sunglasses. I always keep them with me. Then I have my Louis Vuitton long wallet. Isn't it beautiful? That goes in here as well. And finally, I have this giant makeup bag, which for some reason I can't seem to downsize from. So even though I don't wear a lot of makeup, I still always carry all of this stuff with me. And that's going to go in the bag too. So all of that put in there, and still there's a lot of room left. You could still tuck other things inside there. So that is one of the advantages of the Epi. Another thing is that it does not tend to sag on the bottom. When the Speedies are made out of canvas, a lot of times the canvas bags will kind of develop a sag and they'll be curved on the bottom here, but the Epi is a little bit sturdier, and so you can see that even though it's packed with all this heavy stuff, it is not sagging in the middle, and that's one of the distinct advantages of this particular bag. I could wear this bag just about anywhere, and in fact I have. For work, I am required to organize a formal event, and when I do that formal event, I am still working. So even though I'm dressed up, I still need a bag to carry all my paraphernalia, and this is the bag that I always reach for because it goes with everything. It doesn't look like you're all dressed up and you're carrying some big old tote that doesn't really match your outfit. And if I tried to bring a clutch, I wouldn't be able to fit anything in it. So this is the bag that I always reach for whenever I'm going to a formal event. So if you are considering purchasing the Speedy and we're thinking about it possibly in the Epi, then I can guarantee you that it's certainly going to last and last and last, because this is 16 years now and it still looks as beautiful as the day I got it. So if this review was helpful for you, I certainly hope that you will give me a thumbs up, and I'll be seeing you again soon with a lot more videos about bags from my personal collection. Thanks for watching. Bye.